Hello and a very warm welcome to Istora Stadium here in Jakarta, where, as you've seen, badminton has a fanatical following. We're here for the BCA Indonesian Open, the sixth event on the 12 tournament MetLife BWF World Super Series. Not only the sixth event, but also the third of the five premier events, an even higher tier of tournament within the Super Series. All England, Malaysia have already gone. Denmark and China are the other premier events. And as you can see, the end of season Super Series finals. The destination once again this year is Dubai, because the end of season championships for the top eight players and pairs in each of the five disciplines will qualify for the destination Dubai World Super Series finals. First of the Super Series finals staged in Dubai in December last year. And what a success it was. The players loved the event in Dubai, and they're already vying for qualifying points, which only happen from the Super Series tournaments towards this year's Destination Dubai World Super Series finals. Well, second day of main round action today, and we've got six matches for you this afternoon. We're starting with women's doubles, and it features the Asian Games gold medalists from Indonesia in the women's doubles. And then we've got men's singles and the beaten finalist from 2013. The left-handed Mark Schwiebler of Germany up against last year's bronze medalist from the World Championships, Tommy Sugiarto of Indonesia. Then men's doubles and the qualifiers, Anggrewan and Saputro up against Endo and Hawakawa, the number six seeds from Japan. Then we turn our attention to men's singles once again, and the 2005 winner, that's 10 years ago, the 35-year-old Lee Kyung-il. Well, 10 years ago, he won the title. Today, he's up against the qualifier, the 17-year-old Jonathan Christie. Then mixed doubles, and we've got the defending champions from Denmark up against the Asian Games bronze medalist Jordan and Susanto of Indonesia. Then women's singles, the last of our matches today, and Xu Yaqing of Chinese Taipei up against the three-time former champion Saina Nehwal of India. So that's our lineup for today. What a great lineup it is. I'm Jill Clark, delighted to say that once again I've got Steen Petersen sitting beside me as we look at the draw for the women's doubles. The first of our matches, of course, women's doubles, and this is the bottom quarter of the draw. And we're going to concentrate on the top section of that bottom quarter. So it's Maswari and Polly from Indonesia up against Supajirakul and Teurat Tanachai of Thailand. So the Indonesian Asian Games gold medalists from last year, Maswari and Polly, the number six seeds, their opponents not seeded. Of course, no two seeds can meet in the last 16 of the draw, which is where we are at the moment, because there's only eight seeds. So here come the young Thailand pair, Putita Supajirakul and Sapsari Teurat Tanachai. And here, the home favourites, Gracia Polly and Nitya Krasinda Meswari, won the Asian Games gold medal in Incheon in Korea last year. And that probably their most outstanding result so far in world terms. So Steen, for all players other than home players, it's quite an experience playing here in Istora Stadium, because there's such fanatical support for the Indonesians.
Yeah, and every player I've talked to absolutely love it, because the fan base is such knowing of badminton, and it doesn't really matter that you play against them, because you just love that people are sort of interested in what you do.
Yeah, the atmosphere. I know it's one of the most iconic venues in the world of badminton. Every player wants to play in Istora Stadium. And as you can hear already, the crowd very much involved in today's matches. Four courts in action here in Istora Senayan. And for these two pairs. Well, both of them won in two straight games in yesterday's first round match. But for the Thailand pair, well, they are at a career high of 13 in the world rankings. Their win-loss record for the year, 9 previous individual tournaments. They reached the semi-final of the India Grand Prix gold and a quarter-final at the Asia Championships. They haven't been playing together all that long, as you can see. They only formed their partnership in June of 2013. Well, their first round against the Indonesians, Melati, by the way, was a beaten finalist here at the Indonesian Open in 2011 when she was playing with Vita Marissa. Well, they beat the Indonesians, as you can see, in 38 minutes. So to the number 6 seeds from Indonesia, Gracia Poli, the 27-year-old, and Nitya Prasinda Nagaswari, 26. So considerably older than their opponents, who are just 19 and 23. And as you can see, their world ranking at the moment, a career high of 7. So both pairs at a career high on the world rankings at the moment. Now, they reached the quarterfinal of this event 2 years ago, losing out to the eventual champions, Bao Yixin and Chen Shu. And they had little problem against the American pair yesterday of Lee and Orbanyana. 13 and 10, very straightforward, just under the 30-minute mark. So for the Indonesian pair, well, they're looking for their 5th quarterfinal of the year. They haven't yet progressed beyond a quarterfinal stage. And as you can see, this is the 2nd meeting between these two pairs. The 5th meeting was in the last 16 of last year's China Super Series. It doesn't actually say, but that was the China Open of 2014. And as you can see, it was pretty convincing for the Indonesians. But I think it's fair comment to say that the Thailand pair, Steen, have very much improved in the last 12 months or so. I think a career high of 13, and that's reflected by the fact that they have been playing much better.
Yeah, and I really think it's an interesting pair, especially the tall girl, Putita, that we haven't seen a whole lot, but she definitely has potential in my book. Sapsiray has been playing some singles and some mixed doubles earlier, so really interesting to be following this Thailand pair further on.
Yeah, absolutely. And Putita Supajirakul only turned 19 6 days ago, last Friday. So she really is very much a youngster. So the Indonesian pair will start nearest to us. The young Thailand pair, far side of the court.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Nitya Prasinda, Miss Wari, Gracia Poli, Indonesia. And on my left, Putia Supajirakul, subsidiary Thai Kracha, Thailand. Subsidiary to serve to Great Poli, level play.
So Sapsiri Peratanachai getting this women's doubles match underway. What a good opening rally. Was that a broken string or a broken racket? There was a bit of a clash of rackets, yeah, there, wasn't there? Right. That's a lovely net shot from Nitya Prasinda Nagaswari. Yeah, well taken.
It is over. 2-1.
That's a good serve. Yeah, packed stadium here. Oh my goodness gracious me, what on earth was that?
Four,
we have seen two. Polly from time to time have some troubles with her low serve, but not recently, as I recall it.
Yeah, Asian Games gold medalist looked a little bit nervous at the start of this.
Favorite, it's a little bit double-sided, so to speak, that if you progress to the later stages of the tournament, it's absolutely fantastic playing in front of your home supporters, but in the first one or two rounds it might be a little bit of a pressure as well, because you feel that you sort of have to win the matches, especially here being the seeded combination.
Oh, that's delightful. Serve, return, and third shot, absolutely critical in doubles. Now, that's a little bit worrying, isn't it? That big bandaging on her right wrist there.
I think it's just a precaution.
Oh, yes.
Oh, good attack.
And it's over 6-5.
Yeah, she's a tall player, who's Petita, 182, that's just under 6 foot tall. And probably one of the most talented youngsters in the women's doubles game, I think, on the world tour.
Definitely. Such a tall player, takes a bit more experience to get used to it in this super serious level here, how you can sort of exploit your strength and cover your weaknesses.
Yeah, I think that's a very good point, and I think that's reflected in the fact that this young Thailand pair have never progressed past the last 16 of a super series event, by my reckoning. This is their 8th R16 Super Series match. Wow. And looking for their first quarter final. It does take time, doesn't it?
7-0.
Especially Premier Super Series.
Premier, all the top 10 best players, pairs in the world are present. Sometimes in the Super Series you can get a little bit of a weaker field from time to time.
It's over 8-7.
Well, the first service fault of the match called on the Suari. Oh, behind the back from Polly. Oh. But in the end, to no avail, my goodness me, that was
9-7.
Acrobatic, wasn't it? Great spatial awareness. I don't think we're going to see it. We're only seeing the final shot, but around the back shot there from Gracie and Holly. That one there, that was tremendous. Just long, good judgments. Now, Steen, this stadium is renowned for the drift. Just explain it to us a little bit.
Yeah, there's in all major stadiums, there's always some kind of drift due to the audience moving around, doors opening, and sometimes air conditioning. But this stadium here is really, really difficult because the drift is actually different on all four courts. Normally, you have quite similar drift on all the courts, but that's not the case here. So we believe that the drift is going from Poli and Crescenda towards the Thailand pair, but the side drift is probably going from left to right.
Well, the Indonesians getting away with another not such good serve from Gracia Poli. Service fault called. This time called on Gracia Poli. Racket not pointing in a downward direction. Good aggression from Lasuari. And the Indonesians have the narrowest of possible advantages at the mid-game interval. Just 1 point in it. Eng Kiang, their coach. Of course, he was the 2004 Olympic bronze medalist for the Flandre Olympic. Yeah, fair bit of instruction. Gracia Poli looked a little confused there.
And it's always a question how much you should sort of try to tell the players during the intervals, because if you tell too much, their minds might still be sort of processing the information when you start playing the first rally of the later part of the game.
Confirming what you told us, Steen. Couple flying a little bit quicker to go towards that far end. Oh, that is delightful. And I know you're a big fan of that little change of pace with all doubles players.
Yeah. We see way too often players just play fast, fast, fast. And it's so efficient to just sort of play a little bit of a soft touch once in a while. I have a feeling that we'll slowly see the Indonesians take control over this game here. Being more experienced and used to play together. Excellent smash here, and exactly this girl, Sapsuray, which is very, very talented, but I still find her as a little bit of the weak point in the Thailand combination, because I think she's a little bit undisciplined. Like, you see a lot of Thai players that are exceptionally well talented on the technical side of it, but sort of is enjoying themselves a little bit too much on the court.
Well, it's very, very interesting that you say that, Steen, because, of course, she used to be a women's singles player. In fact, she won the gold medal at the 2010 Youth Olympics in Singapore and reached three finals in international terms in the women's singles. And she gave up women's singles because she said it's too much hard work.
Yeah.
So that just emphasizes, and she's actually brought that, I wouldn't say lazy, that's far too strong, but she's a little too relaxed.
But
on court,
she enjoys playing, and she plays the shot that is good in the moment, that feels right for her in the moment, but perhaps not the tactically correct shot. Sometimes you have to play a little bit boring in order to protect yourself and to protect your partner.
Now, good interception. And again. Good rally.
Well played.
And that's the sort of shot that identifies to me what a talent she is.
Yeah.
Just guiding the shuttle across court into the open space. First of all, the interceptions, two of them during that rally.
Yeah, and it's interesting that Sapsuray said that the singles was too much hard work, because I think actually ladies doubles is even more hard work, just in another manner.
Yeah.
It's a lot about physical strength in women's doubles.
You cannot imagine how delighted I am to hear you say that, Steen. Yeah. Well, she may have made the error, but once again, I like the idea. Good defense. Brilliant.
16-13.
Fabulous rally. And I do like the acute angle on the final shot. That was the one that did all the damage. Look at that.
6-13.
Yeah, that is magnificent, isn't it?
14.
Lovely, lovely interception. 16. She also seems to have that awareness of where to try and place the shuttle. We were talking about that a couple of weeks ago, weren't we, about Zhao Yunlei, the world and Olympic champion.
And there is some players who just have this excellent read and sort of always place the shuttle where it hurts the most to the opponent.
But single match number 22, Dionysius Ayomorubaka. This is Janko Jokensen, Denmark. Fire, Elaine Koch, USA. Sebijan, Maria Zubidurosuna.
Look at the chance she was taking here.
15-17.
She takes a step forward, senses it, it's going to be a flat smash.
Do you like that sort of risk taking, or is that a little over-ambitious? She got away with it on that occasion, obviously.
Yeah. I have mixed feelings for it because I like putting pressure on the opponents, that you should know that if you're not sort of making the right shots, you'll be there, but to a certain degree, because otherwise it's maybe too risky. I mean, why not play on and sort of win it in a regular rally?
So that's perhaps the sort of scenario that takes them from being a 13 in the world to a top 10 pair, where they
figuring out when to take the chances. We've seen another Thai player, Sutket Papakamal, in the mixed doubles, who has won a world championship bronze medal, and when he plays his best, he sort of gets this creativity and risk-taking really well mixed up with his efficient game.
Now, for me, just as a purist fan, you see, I love all the risk taking. But you look at it from the coach's role of trying to get the player or the pair to the very top in elite badminton, whereas I just look at it from that's great. I love all that. Yeah. That's why you're the coach and I'm not.
16-19.
Flick serve. Yeah, set up the rally. Very good.
17-19.
And very nice to see the Indonesian players not complain to the service judge, because that's what we often see. Every time a flick serve is served, we have complaints afterwards.
Well.
19.
Just 1 point the deficit now. Short. Yeah, back level.
94.
Four straight points. Yeah, greeted with a stunned silence from the fans here. And even the dive from Gracia Poli. Not able to retrieve the situation.
Thank you. Play.
Interception again. What a rally. Brilliant.
Absolutely fantastic defense from Poli and Maheshwari. There it is. The winning shot.
So a game point opportunity for the Indonesians. To be 20 all. That's well saved. Good courage by the Thailand youngsters. And it's 20 all, and we will require extra points until it's a clear 2-point winning margin. Plenty of encouragement from the two Indonesians to each other. Well, you could tell immediately, couldn't you, by the service action, there was no real push through. And that looked a nervous serve to me. And that gives a second game point opportunity to the Indonesians. Oh, dear me, that's not the best of serves again, but it is converted by the Asian Games gold medalists. 22-20.
Miss Wally, Lucia, Holly E, 22-20.
Yeah, got in a tangle on her defensive play, Teirat Tanachai. Yeah, did a full pirouette as well.
She's so good at covering that left shoulder, Maheshwari. Goes around and hits the forehand shot. Very, very efficient.
So the opening game, 22-20 in 23 minutes. Well, the Indonesians pushed all the way in that opening game. Yeah, like the fact that they're involved in the discussions. Yeah, Gracia Poli saying what she thinks should be happening as well. And now Maheshwari, I really do like to see that. Yeah. That the players heavily involved with the coaches. And that's unusual in Asia, isn't it?
Court one, 20 seconds.
I think it's not so often we see it, but we tend to see it more and more from the earlier days where it sort of was a one-way communication.
Yeah.
Of course, it creates ownership of the game plan with the players.
Second game, Lavo play.
I do think it's awfully important that the Thailand pair keep at least close at the start of this second game, because I think that the Indonesians are great front runners, and I think there's a danger that they could run away with this.
Yeah. Also, must be devastating for Fujita and Sapsuray losing the first game after catching up.
Yeah.
Broke the string. Fujita.
Bronze medalist at the World Junior Championships of 2013 with Narasapat Lam.
Okay, play. Two, love. Play.
And we haven't seen her a while.
No.
Because I thought she was really good as well.
Yeah.
And I think eventually we might see two Thailand ladies that will sort of competing for glory at the international stage. We've got, of course, got that. We've got two ladies doubles. We've got three with Arun Kason and Ravichi Chaikul as the most experienced one.
Narasapat Lam win the Thailand Grand Prix gold a couple of years back, playing with Sarali.
Tung Tung Kam.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Rally. Brilliant.
And they've really come out attacking the Indonesian pair here in the second game. Feels that's the best way of neutralizing the tall Fujita Supadirakul.
Oh my goodness me, where on earth did that come from? That was brilliant. What a backhand.
Yeah.
Totally unexpected.
My love.
He's here every year. We love him. Great character.
And that's what all the players love by playing here, that the spectators, they're having a party.
Yeah. That's another good shot from Polly.
Oh, she's playing fantastic right now.
Six.
I was actually just sitting thinking that the players have been controlling the drift quite well, but I think we saw two mistakes here due to the side drift, left to right.
Oh, that's nice. Yeah, good serve. It wasn't a bad return,
three.
But the third shot there.
Six.
From Petita, absolutely superb. Well, has gone well long. Yeah, this is a good little comeback by the Thailand youngsters. A very good comeback. Five straight points. I really thought it. Six love. I thought the Indonesians were stamping their authority on this match.
This is particularly one of the shots I don't like because it was a big, big opportunity and was immediately turned into a loser. So just by sort of keeping the pressure, making the opportunity a little bit bigger on the next shot, they would have been almost certain of winning that. Great defense.
Joyce landed in. Yep, came back in, held up with the drift. Yeah, she could have played it. Yeah, that's plumb on the line.
It's over 6-8.
Great awareness of where the gap was. Wasn't the easiest shot to play either.
It was a little behind her, I think.
Yeah.
Subsaray, but also good counter defense from Maheswari. A nice use of the mid-court area from Gracia Poli, and that means that she and Maheswari have a 5-point advantage here in the second game at the mid-game interval, having already won the first. And again we see one of these a little bit longer rallies where it seems to me that the Thailand pair runs out of ideas. If the defense is good from Maheswari and Poli, they sort of get tempted to play a little bit lackluster shots. And that gets punished by the Indonesians.
11-6.
Oh my goodness, how did she get that back? What a wonderful, wonderful disguise drop shot from Gracia Poli. You can see from that just how close it was to the net. The drop shot landing way inside that front service line. An indication of just what precision on the drop shot.
And at this stage, it's almost 1.5 point because of the cheer that they get for winning such an outstanding rally.
12-6.
So one game up and 12-6 lead in the second. That's really comforting, and just wants to play here forever.
Well, it almost came back in, but not quite. I'm surprised about that. Maybe this drift is forever changing. It wouldn't be at all surprising because as doors get opened in the stadium, it does.
And I don't think it's as significant on the 2 meter court as it is on the courts on the side. So that's also very, very difficult to sort of adapt to when you perhaps played one of the outer courts yesterday and then you're suddenly on one of the 2 middle courts today. And the drift is of a different power or speed, so to speak.
Well, in case you're wondering what all the noise is about, I can tell you that the junior player, Anthony Binting, has just beaten the number 4 seed, Srikant Kidambi, on one of the adjoining courts.
Good defense there.
Oh, delightful.
She's lost a racket.
Oh, my goodness. Fabulous.
They're not giving up easily. The two girls from Thailand.
Thank you.
You'll see some training exercises where the players play three against three, and you're only allowed to have two players on court at a time. And when you've hit the shuttle, you have to run out of the court and the sort of reserve player comes in. That's also a lot of fun, but it almost reminded me of that training exercise here when both Thailand girls 14. Went down on the floor.
Yeah, they just needed the reserve.
Thank you.
good serve. I do like the way Mazzuari moves forward. She hits from the back and makes her way forward. And that's the sides formation, attacking formation that you've been talking about in recent tournaments.
Yeah, it gets more and more difficult as the defense gets better and better. It's more and more difficult to sort of set the net player up for an kill. Here, Poli succeeded in setting up Mazzuari. I must say that we've seen quite a phenomenal development in ladies' doubles over the last 4 or 5 years. I remember once there was a lot of clear and drops and sort of players trying to outlast each other. That's definitely not the case anymore.
No.
And in some ways, it's actually sometimes more entertaining to see than men's doubles, because there's so much emphasis on the service situation in the men's doubles. So we see such short rallies. And here we've seen a number of beautiful rallies.
Yeah.
It's over 12-17.
She got back. My goodness me, behind the back shot. It's gone long. Oh, what a good rally. That behind the back shot from Teurat Tanachai was absolutely sensational.
Service over 13-18.
Very difficult to pick up straight that smash from Poli because of the drift. It just takes it wide.
So the Indonesians now 2 points away from a second quarter final to go with the quarter final achieved 2 years 19. Ago.
Okay, 19.
Kuntita. She's played very well throughout the match, but now the Indonesians on the verge of more celebrations because Maswari and Polly have 5 match point opportunities. Best of serves, but got away with it.
17-20.
Rally. Oh, that was going wide, wasn't it? Oh, and that's landed in. Will they challenge? No. No challenge from the Thailand pair. So the Asian Games gold medalists, Gracia Polly and Nidia Krishinda Maswari, through to the quarterfinal once again. 22-20, 21-17. In 48 minutes. It's the final rally. I thought that might have been going wide. Well, no appeal. Well, she must have known it was in. Instant review system in operation on our number one court here. But that, the first of our matches, was concluded without Hawkeye being asked to adjudicate once. Now you can just see how tall Kuntita is there, towering above the other players.
Yihang, China versus Karin Sanasi, Germany. Umpire Tommy Oskariano, Indonesia. Service judge Abdul Latif Jauhari. 2024. Please welcome the technical official. The umpire of the match, Carol Yardil, Ireland. And the
so after that excellent women's doubles, we turn our
Christy
attention
Kong,
now to men's
Malaysia.
Singles, and this is the bottom quarter of the draw. And just look at that, the two-time Olympic champion, Lin Dan, the number two seed, didn't progress past the first round, beaten by Tommy Sugiarto. And he's up against Mark Zwiebler. Mark Zwiebler, the former European champion and former finalist here at the Indonesian Open. Reached the final 2 years ago, Mark Zwiebler, unseeded, lost in the final to Lee Chong Wei. In fact, reached the final here 2 years ago without playing against another seeded player.
Mark Zwiebler.
That's an extraordinary run for Mark Zwiebler in 2013. And there he is.
From
the 2012 European champion.
Sugiarto.
And Tommy Sugiarto, the man who turned 27 4 days ago, semi-finalist here 2 years ago. And who did he lose to in that semi-final?